Well, I was lucky enough to be brought up on a golf course on the south coast of England, which is one of the hilliest golf courses in the country, actually, near Eastbourne. And so basically, you either learnt a very good knowledge of how uneven lies affected your game, or you lost every single golf ball in your bag during a round. So growing up in that environment, I was very aware of the calculations and the judgments that you make when you're playing a golf course that's sloping. When I moved to a much flatter part of the world, though, I found people were much less knowledgeable about the subject. And in actual fact, a lot of people play the game basically not taking their lie into account. And it's a very major reason why people are inaccurate and they can't hit the target. So about 6 months ago, I started doing some more formal research by consulting various professional golfers, both about the actual technical issues that cause a golf ball to fly offline, but also a little bit about how they approach that topic when, say, they're playing in a tournament. And you can see a little interview on the website with Matthew Hazeldin, who's an ex-tour pro, about how he would assess his lie on a golf course, and that's quite interesting. But there was also quite a bit of geometry and maths that I did research into to exactly explain why the lie does throw your ball offline. A lot of it is not really to do with your swing, it's actually to do with the geometry of the golf club. And people aren't aware of that. So in these films, you'll see very clear explanations of why that happens. And that was just simply a process of mathematical research, really, doing the calculations, which I was fortunate enough to be able to do.